Well, thank you once again for joining me here in my wood shop. I want to disclaim this video by telling you it's not an instructional video or how-to video. Purely entertainment purposes only. And as you'll see, kind of make it up as I go. I'm flying by the seat of my pants. Hope you enjoy it. This is a heavily spalted oak log I got off the internet, eBay. Heavily spalted. I don't know where spalting and rotting, where that line is, but as you can see, it's pretty well destroyed. I use the majority of that for a larger project, which you'll see in the future. And the scraps, I sanded down, flat-sided, and pieced it together. As you can see here, this is going to be the base of the green Kingsley whiskey glass. After making that manzanita glass, the wood just kind of flowed, and it's one of those things where you look at a piece of wood and you say, hey, that looks like a glass. Those pieces look like the pieces I want to use. After that, I had a hard time coming up with something, and that's what I came up with. So I didn't film the part where I glued those together with 5-minute epoxy, which I tinted with a green, which I like very much, Green Envy mica powder, which has some gold in it from Black Diamond Pigments.
So I got this at the thrift store for $1.99. I bought a bunch of different sizes. And this looks to be about the right size for this. So the reason I bought these vases for $99 to $299 was the beakers. They weren't too expensive, but these were the two good sizes I found. And these were $17 from Amazon. Haven't used them yet. Okay, so my idea here is to use the penetrating epoxy. And one of the reasons I did that instead of cactus juice was I glued these together with a pigmented epoxy. And I couldn't bake them in the oven. Although, you see on the bottom here, it got a little brown. I was in the shop last night wondering what the hell is smelling. It smells like burnt wood. And I was doing some other stuff. And I forgot I left the oven on with these at the door open, with these in there to dry out. So, they're dry. And so anyways, I didn't want to use the cactus juice and then bake these in the oven because I had put the epoxy and glued that together. So I got the penetrating epoxy. We'll see how that works. I don't know if this is going to work. Probably just going to make a big old mess. That's probably not going to be a good idea. is like water. And it clears up. It's a little milky when you first pour it. Clears up to be crystal clear. Okay, let's see. Cycled it once. I'm gonna swap these around and see if I'm actually gonna take the bottom one out and put the top one in. Okay, let's see if we have enough to I think I can feel it starting to get a little thicker. So, I'm making two more of these. I just measured this, and it's pretty much damn right on 6.5 ounces, which is what they're supposed to be, I guess. Anyways, so I want this voided area to fall on that lip. So I'm going to recut this. I've traced around and I've made a ghost ring around there. What do you call that? So I'm going to recut that and then I'll center. All right, so I got my homemade sander, sanding disc, and I made this plate that actually will easily go right in the tool rest. And it shimmed, so it's centered. And it's 90 degrees. So that's how I can square things up. I'm pretty pleased in how these lightened up. I wasn't really digging on how dark they got with that penetrating epoxy. I was kind of a little bummed, but when you get into it, it's light again. So that's good.
So as you watch, this part is pretty self-explanatory. trying to keep the same spacing and general size of the first glass I made. These are protein canisters that I've cut the tops and bottoms off of. They really do work good. The hot glue sticks to it very well, and the resin just doesn't. You see there's two there. There's a purple one I made as well, and that will be posted in a later video. That's Black Diamond Pigments Green Envy and Pure Gold or Aztec Gold. I can't remember which one it was. As you see, there's actually some gold in that green. My guesstimator was off a little, so I had to mix up another small batch of clear to top that off. Now my idea, of course, was to make it as, you know, clear, so after it was polished, you could, you know, it wasn't fogged up by the colors, but yet have some streaks and streams of color in it. And I kind of jab that stick down there to drop some of the color that's poured on the bottom. Oops. In the pressure pot you go, the green one and the purple one. I do fill this to 50 PSI. It leaks down about 10 pounds overnight, which isn't a big deal. My compressor, I think, is regulated at 100 PSI. I do have a separate regulator with a water separator. On this line, just above it, at 50 PSI, and I've regulated the pressure pot at 50 PSI as well.
Gold. We shall see.
I do change from a 5/8 inch bowl gouge to this square carbide cutter from time to time. I guess it just depends on whether or not I want to sharpen tools or not. Once again, using that original manzanita glass I made for a rough template as far as a overall size. Switched over to some smaller detailing tools. I think that's like a 12 millimeter square carbide and a 11 or 12 millimeter round. There's also a diamond shaping tool in there to get to the tight spots. Of course, now we come across some holes, fill them with CA glue. Did that a couple times. I'm not going to bore you with a lot of sanding, but there was a lot of sanding. Get a little sneak preview of that with a sanding sealer just to seal up the wood and then start wet sanding. I really like this Blue Point micro buffer. Has a 3-inch 3M pad on it. Polish that up with some brown and some blue rouge. After wet sanding it, remove the tail support. Clean up the base here. I've already put a dovetail tenon on it. Didn't want any lateral movement. Snap that puppy off. Time to turn it around and get to hogging it out. I wanted to make sure this was running true before I fired this puppy up or really cinched down on that chuck. Looks good to me. Let's run it.
Now you see what I mean by this getting chattery. I cleaned that up and it's got all kinds of tool marks in it, so I'm up for some quite a bit of sanding. So I'm gonna quit messing with that and call that good. It's looking pretty good. It's got a nice even contour. I got a bit of sanding to do, so I'll be able to clean that up. All right, get the sanding.
Well, back to sanding. I sanded this up to 1,000, which was pretty smooth, but you can still see some lines, which was fine because I chose to go with a resin finish. And once you put the resin on, it blends everything in. That didn't work out quite as well as I was hoping.
All right, we just mixed up bunch of resin here, some alumilite. We're gonna coat the inside of this glass, throw it on the lathe, let it cure.
Didn't really turn out quite the way I wanted it to. So unfortunately, after letting the stuff kind of set up for weeks and weeks, I decided to send it all back off and sand and sand and sand. And went with a CA finish. The reason I chose to take it off, it just didn't, the clarity wasn't there. It was soft. And I've been using a lot of CA on pens with really good results. So that's what we went with. After having so much trouble with the original glass flying off the lathe and getting this far with this project, I didn't want to take any chances, so I wrapped it in a paper towel and some blue tape, broke out the Easy Wood carbide parting tool, which worked flawless, highly recommend it. Now for some finished work here. Did sand it up to 400, put some sanding sealer on it. That's a 2-inch hook and loop backing pad with just a paper towel. That and the axe abrasive paste, sanding paste, polishes that up great. Now this is the axe polishing paste. I know you're supposed to buff this on, but of course it's not in the lathe anymore. I'm done with the lathe, not putting it back on. And just to let that soak into the wood, kind of bring out to treat it, and bring out the grain, put a pretty liberal amount on there. And let it sit for a while. Took some of it off to see what the finish would be look like. Now, as you can see, there's a little bit of fogging, like right there. Don't know why. Little bum, but overall very pleased with the end result. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. If you like this one, I have several others on my YouTube channel, OC Resin Works. Please like and subscribe. Have a wonderful day and be safe.